something happens tomorrow and you're the only one who knows how to cook, well, you will be a very important person. Hello, everyone. If you had the chance to check out my other videos, I definitely appreciate it. And if you have the chance to check out my blog, I also equally appreciate it. It means a lot to me, and I have a lot of exciting videos to share with you in the upcoming weeks. Today, I wanted to talk to you about homemaking. Now, homemaking does not have a good rap. So, homemaking, the process of beautifying a home, the process of pouring love into a home, the process of giving life and caring for the people that are in that said home, is not something that's completely popular nowadays. And the reason that I know this is from experience. When I first became married, and I say first became married because that is when I stepped into having my own home, I did not know a thing about homemaking. I did not think before I was married that it was relevant. I thought, okay, I'm gonna get a house cleaner. I'm gonna buy the stuff that I can make quickly. Establishing routines in my household is something that will come very easily to me. But boy, was I wrong. Homemaking is about so much more than those superficial things that we think that it is. So much more than just organization. It really has to do with putting your spirit, putting who you are into your home. I know that me saying that is kind of not a very good motivating reason for you to begin honing on your homemaking practices. And for that reason, I have decided to share 5 reasons why I believe that you should care about homemaking. Number one is the fact that somebody has to do it. Now, there are opportunities in our life where we are called by God, karma, the universe, whatever you believe in, to be a leader. Being a leader in your home in the sense of homemaking can really be one of those callings. So somebody has to be the first one to implement these types of systems, love, pouring in to one's home, and you can be the person that does that. Take this opportunity to express those leadership skills or to develop some leadership skills yourself. It is a safe space to fail in your home. Reason number 2 has to do with creating a warm and inviting place in your home. You deserve a place where you can come in from the rest of the world, feel at peace, feel at ease, and just generally want to make some memories. Just generally want to spend time with your loved ones, put your feet up, relax, be your authentic self. This is super important for your mental and physical health. And becoming a good homemaker is a way that you can show love towards your family. It is also kind of a selfish way that you can make your home the place where memories happen. So instead of just going out and creating memories outside your home can act like a sort of magnet where people are attracted to just because it's got that extra little special touch. And when you have everybody under your own roof, I guarantee you will make some of the best memories of your life. Think about it. Think about traditions. Think about holidays. Think about those homes in your family that maybe just were always the meeting place. Maybe you want that home to be yours. Number 3 is the fact that you have been given the gift of home. So, like I mentioned before, God, karma, the universe, whatever you believe in, you have been given this unique gift of home. People go their whole lives wishing that they had a home, and you have one. So take advantage of that, hone on your homemaking practices, make your home special, make your home unique, make it a reflection of who you are. Reason number 4 is efficiency. So, in terms of the logical reasons why homemaking is great, when you hone on your homemaking skills and you become a good homemaker, you will become efficient because you cannot really get to that love part of homemaking without getting to that practical part of homemaking. So you have to establish those cleaning routines, those cooking routines, and these can become very efficient in your life because they will over time save you a lot of time and energy. I know for myself, it took me a while to learn how to cook. It took me a while to learn how to clean. But once I did that, I can do it so fast. In fact, girl, I cleaned my whole house this morning. That would normally take me a whole week. Reason number five is that homemaking is a practical skill. So all of the things that we mentioned that come along with homemaking, all of those first baby steps, these are all things that you can pass down to your children, as well as just the feeling of a warm, cozy home. Your children will inherit this feeling and they will want to replicate it in their own home. Make your home someplace special. It is actually very practical to learn how to cook, to learn how to clean, to learn how to decorate for a number of reasons. Something happens tomorrow and you're the only one who knows how to cook? Well, you will be a very important person. And more realistically though, you can help decorate, I don't know, your children's school. There's just a number of reasons why homemaking can be very useful. So I'd love to get into more details, more examples, more ways that I do it, which I will do in the upcoming weeks, but I wanted to give you this kind of little motivating video, this little brief summary video of why I believe that homemaking is important and why you should care. So I wanted to say goodbye, and I hope you can check out my other videos. I really, really, really appreciate it.